Buddha was staying at the monastery of Vishakha in Savatthi. Every evening, a large number of people used to gather around him to listen to his sermons on Dhamma and to participate in meditations. One of the regulars at his sermons was an accountant named Moggallana. He had been listening to sermons of Buddha for many years now. But he felt that he had not gained anything out of his sermons and was very disturbed with this thought. He used to come to listen to Buddha nearly every day but was not putting any of his teachings into practice. He thought that he should ask Buddha himself regarding why he was not gaining anything out of his teachings though he was regular to his Dhamma summons. Finally, one day he gathered enough courage and went to him quite early, before the scheduled time of his sermon. He bowed to Buddha and requested, "Sir, I have a query. I thought I must ask you only the answer to the question that has kept me disturbed for the past many years." Buddha looked at the young man and asked calmly, "Tell me, son, what do you want to know? What is troubling you?" Moggallana asked, "Sir, I have observed that many persons who attend your sermons have achieved significant spiritual progress. Some have even attained the state of ultimate liberation. But there are a lot of listeners, including me, who have not gained anything out of it. Or if they have gained anything at all, it is too insignificant. Why is that so? Sir, you have achieved the state of ultimate enlightenment. You have subdued Mara and are regarded as the most powerful and most compassionate on the earth. Why, despite listening to the sermons from the Lord Himself, we are not progressing? And why the most compassionate on the earth is not using his unsurpassed powers to liberate us all?" Buddha looked at him with a smile and calmly asked, "Son, where are you from? Where do you live?" Moggallana replied, "Sir, I live here only, in Savatthi, the capital city of the kingdom of Kaushal." Buddha asked again, "But your facial features and dialect do not appear to be local. What is your native place?" Moggallana said, "Sir, you are right. My native place is Rajgir, the capital of the kingdom of Magad." Buddha asked him, "So do you still visit Rajgir, or have you settled here permanently?" The young accountant responded, "Sir, I have my family and my business there in Rajgir, so I frequently visit Rajgir from Savatthi." Buddha asked again, "Do you know the path of Rajgir from Savatthi?" The young man said, "Yes, sir, of course. In fact, I know the path so well that I can reach Rajgir from Savatthi even blindfolded. It's simple. We need to go south up to Banaras, and from there we have to travel towards east. Finally, after crossing Gaya, we reach Rajgir." Buddha asked, "So has it ever happened that any of your friends have asked you about the path to Rajgir? And if they have asked, have you explained the path to them clearly without hiding anything from them?" Moggallana said, "Yes, sir. Many times my friends have asked me about the path, as they know I have traveled several times between these two cities. There is nothing to hide, and I tell them everything regarding the path as clearly as possible." Buddha smiled and asked, "So when you explain the path to them, and after having learned the path, your friends must have reached Rajgir instantly and magically without having to travel on the path." Moggallana said, "Sir, what are you saying? This is not possible. Only those travelers who walk on the path till the end and follow all instructions and directions will reach Rajgir. How can they reach their destination by simply listening to my directions and guidance, however clearly I explain it to them?" Buddha replied with compassion, "Son, that's all I have been trying to explain to you. You cannot reach liberation simply by listening or memorizing my sermons and teachings. You need to walk on the path. Those who have taken one step are one step closer to their final goal. Those who have taken 1,000 steps are 1,000 steps closer to their goal. And those who have traveled to the end of the path have reached the final liberation. But those who were satisfied just with listening to my teachings or attending my Dhamma sessions cannot reach their goal simply by listening to the sermons. You need to take responsibility for your liberation. You need to walk on the path. And you need to walk on the path all by yourself.